Hello everyone, today we will be covering second part of food processing, food fortification and food adulteration. Food toxicants. A toxic or poisonous substance might be present in anybody's food. In small quantity, a substantial toxic effect may not be there, but in higher doses or chronic consumption may prove fatal. So these are the examples of the few food toxicants. So in some bananas, we have 5-hydroxytryptamine or adrenaline or noradrenaline present as toxic ingredients. It can affect our central or peripheral nervous system. In some type of cheese, we have tyramine, which can alter our blood pressure. In few almonds and cassava, we have cyanides, which can hamper tissue respiration. In some fishes and meat, nitrosamines are present, which can cause cancers. If mustard oil is adulterated with argemone oil, sanguinarine is present, which can cause epidemic dropsy. Kesari dal has a toxic ingredient present is B-N-oxylamino-L-aniline and others, which can cause neurolethargism. Brassica species have glucosinoids, thiocyanate, which can cause goiter. Green potato can have solanine, which can cause gastrointestinal upset. Few mushrooms have various toxins, which can have multiple CNS effects. Groundnuts have aflatoxin, which can cause aflatoxicosis. So we will be covering few of them. The first one is lethargism. The term lethargism was coined by Cantoni in Italy. It is a neurodegenerative disorder that causes neurolethargism in human beings and osteolethargism or odoratism in animals. Neurolethargism occurs mostly in those consuming it as a staple pulse. Example, diets containing over 30% of this dal consumed for more than 6 months may result in this disease. In India, few districts of Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, Assam and Gujarat have reported the cases of lethargism. Agent: Lethyrus sativus, Kesari dal, which is also referred to as Teora dal or Lak dal, Baltra, Matra and Grass pea. It appears similar to Arhar dal, Red gram or Bengal gram. If carefully examined, the lethargic seeds are triangular in shape and grayish in color. It is cheap, but it is a good source of protein. Lethargic sativus contains beta-N-oxylaminoalanine, that is BOAA, a neurotoxin responsible for a neurolethargism. Contents of BOAA toxin in seeds varies from 0.2 gram percent to 1.0 gram percent. These are water soluble, so this property of water soluble can be made use for removing the toxin. So first you soak the pulse in hot water and then discard the soaked water. BOA was extracted in 1962 from the common vetch that normally grows as bead in Lethyrus sativus. BOA causes neurolethargism in humans, and the toxin in the pulse which causes osteolethargism or odoratism in animals is beta-aminopropionitrite, BAPN. So BOA causes neurolethargism in humans and BAPN causes osteolethargism or odoratism in animals. Age and sex. So it commonly affects the men in the age group 15 to 45 years. In the occupation, it is associated with agriculture laborers. Pathogenesis. BOA is a neurotoxin that has affinity for nerve cells of upper motor neurons. So there is a loss of axis cylinders with gliosis of crossed pyramid tracts in the lumbar and lumbosacral spinal cord, leading to paraplasia. The sensory system and the motor nerves to muscle of trunk, upper limbs and sphincter are spared. Lesions are reversible only in early latent stages of the illness. Latent period. It varies from 1 month to 3 months depending on the amount of pulse consumed. Clinical features. The clinical symptoms of the disease lethargism are acute in onset, often preceded by exertion or exposure to cold. A patient may often report as being paralyzed on getting up in the morning. Some cases may give history of backache and stiffness of legs preceding the paralysis of legs. It causes spastic paralysis of lower limbs and action described in the following stages of this disease. The first one is the latent disease. Spasmodic muscular contractions of the calf muscles are earliest symptom. This stage is considered important from the prevention point of view, since at this stage, withdrawal of pulse from the diet, it will result in widespread diminution of the disease. Second stage, no stick stage. The subject takes short jerky steps without using walking stick. And in this stage, Babinski sign is absent. The third stage is one stick stage. The subject walks on toes with a crossed gait and uses stick to make the balance. On examination, ankle clones and Babinski sign are present. The fourth one is the two stick stage. The object walks with crossed legs or seizure gait, you can say, with the support of two crutches because of excessive bending of the knees. The fifth one is the crawler stage. In this stage, knee joints cannot support the weight of the body, so they can't make erect posture. Thigh and leg shows atrophic changes. The patient is able to move by crawling, carrying his weight on his hands. Pyramidal signs are present. Prevention and control of lethargism. Removal of toxin, boa toxins, can be removed by two methods. The first one is the steeping method. In this method, we soak the pulse in hot water for 120 minutes. Since the toxins are water soluble, boa toxin steeps into the water. After 2 hours, soaked water is drained off completely and pulse is again washed using clean water and then sun-dried. The drawback with this method is that water-soluble vitamins and minerals are also lost along with toxin. Second is parboiling. This method is more suitable for large scale. It can be done in two ways. First, the pulse is soaked in lukewarm water like parboiling of rice and then subjected to steam for 15 minutes. The second one is soaking the pulse in lime water overnight and next day it is washed and cooked. Vitamin C prophylaxis. In early stages of the illness, 500 to 1000 mg ascorbic acid given daily for a week or so heals the damages well. Genetic approach. The Indian Agriculture Research Institute, New Delhi, has developed low toxin strains of Lethyrus sativus. Health education. People in the areas where Khesari Dal is cultivated and consumed should be educated about the hazards of using this pulse as part of meal and methods of removal of toxic before cooking. Banning the crop. The Prevention of Food and Adulteration Act in India has banned cultivation, harvesting and consumption of Lethyrus in any form. Practically, it is not feasible to avoid consumption of Khesari Dal, so the proportion of Lethyrus should be limited to less than 25% of the total cereals and pulses consumed every day. The next are aflatoxins. This is a special group of fungal mycotoxins produced under conditions of improper storage, and namely Aspergillus flavus and Aspergillus parasiticus are responsible. Aflatoxicosis is characterized by hepatitis, cirrhosis of liver, and enteritis caused by ingestion of infested food grains. Aflatoxins were first isolated in 1960 in England after reports of death of turkeys fed on infested peanut and cottonseed meal. In 1974, tribal population residing in some 200 villages of Banswara district in Rajasthan and Panchmahal district of Gujarat reported cases with sudden ascites, edema of lower limbs and portal hypertension with some 106 deaths. Investigation revealed that infected maize with Aspergillus flavus in the range of 6.25 to 15.6 6 ppm and affected people consumed some 2000 to 6000 microgram per kg daily for a month of period. Aspergillus flavus or Aspergillus parasiticus are fungi that commonly affect food in suboptimal storage settings such as high temperature between 32 to 37 degree centigrade and humidity above 16%. Commonly seen in the rainy season during floods and near sea regions, the fungus has been observed to infest improperly stored foods like maize, groundnut, jowar, rice, beet, sunflower, tree nuts, and spices, etc. Toxins. Aflatoxin B1 is the most powerful known natural hepatocarcinogen. Another toxin, aflatoxin G1, is also known. Clinical features. This toxin causes hepatitis, ascites, portal hypertension, liver cirrhosis, and even cancer of liver. Prevention and control. Proper storage of food items after drying in dry containers to prevent fungal contamination of the food grains. The moisture content should be kept as low as 10%. This problem can be addressed by educating the general population about the health hazards of consuming contaminated food grains. Ergot. Claviceps are field fungi which infest crops, and most of infestation of the crops occurs during the flowering and seeding stages. The fungi looks like a black mass. Its seeds are black in color and irregular in shape. Ergotism is caused by ingestion of food grains like bajra, rice, wheat, and rye infested by Claviceps fusiformis and Claviceps purpurea. A toxin called ergotamine main causes the illness. In some African countries, scientists have succeeded in isolating the toxin from the blood of a pregnant females, the breast milk, and also from the cord blood with the marked seasonal variations. Generally, 0.05 mg per 100 gram of the food is considered the safe limit for ergot alkaloids. The term ergot is derived from the French word argot, that means spur. Persian literature comments on grass that causes abortion in pregnant ladies and die in childbirth. Clinical features. The clinical symptoms include nausea and vomiting, abdominal cramps, and drowsiness extending up to 24 to 48 hours after consumption of infested grains. In chronic cases, painful cramps in digits and limbs associated with burning, itching, and peripheral gangrene have been documented. Prevention. Floating the ergot infested grains in 20% salt water is a method to remove the infested grains. Hand picking or air flotation can also remove the infested grains. The next one is epidemic dropsy. Epidemic dropsy results from consumption of mustard oil adulterated or contaminated with the oil of Argemon mexicana seeds, that are prickly poppy seeds. Large prickly leaves and bright yellow or white flowers are characteristic of this plant. Mustard, Brassica nigra, and Argemon seeds look alike. Mixing of these two seeds may be deliberate or accidental. In our country, the highest incidence is observed in July-August and lowest in month of April. Problem statement. As per record, the first case of epidemic dropsy from India was reported from Kolkata in the year 1877. Most recently, epidemic has been reported from New Delhi in the year 99, causing over 3,000 hospitalizations and more than 60 deaths. The affected subjects were using mustard oil of company Dhara as cooking media, and that was purchased loose from local vendors. Lab confirms the mixing of Argemon oil with mustard oil. Pathogenesis. Mukherjee et al. Isolated sanguinarin, a toxin from Argemon oil, in 1941. Sarkar et al. Described two toxins, namely in 1948, sanguinarin and dihydrosanguinarin in Argemon oil. Sanguinarin is 2.5 times more toxic than dihydrosanguinarin. Toxin is absorbed from the gut into the circulation. Sanguinarin interferes with the carbohydrate metabolism, leading to accumulation of pyruvic acid. Argemone oil mainly affects blood vessels. Sanguinarine increases the capillary permeability that leads to edema. The duration of exposure is also important. Sanguinarine binds to plasma proteins, and this property helps it to retain in the body for up to 96 hours after ingestion. This may cause cumulative toxicity even with exposure in very small dose. Clinical features. Patient usually present with complaints of watery diarrhea and vomiting of subacute or insidious onset, may persist for 7 to 10 days. Bilateral pitting edema of the lower limbs. History of burning sensation, itching and paresthesis, mild to moderate anemia, hyponatremia, renal azotemia and retinal hemorrhages are also common. Glaucoma is found in 0 to 12% of cases. Dyspnea, cardiac failure and death may follow. Detection of toxin. Nitric acid test. To perform this test, the 5 ml of the oil to be tested and 5 ml of nitric acid taken in a test tube and shaken well. On standing, layer of nitric acid changes its color depending upon the quantity of argemone oil. As quantity of argemone oil increases, color changes from yellow to orange yellow or crimson. The test can detect alteration with more than 0.25% concentration of oil. The major drawback of this test is that high false positive rates are given. So, a positive test should be reconfirmed with other tests. The next test is ferric chloride test. In this test, 2 ml of each of oil to be tested and concentrated hydrochloric acid are taken in a test tube and mixed well. The solution is heated in water bath at 33.5 to 35 degree centigrade for 2 minutes. At this stage, it is reheated again for 1 meter after adding 8 ml of ethyl alcohol. Now 2 ml of ferric chloride is mixed and the tube is heated again in the bath for 10 minutes. If there is argemone oil in the test oil, an orange-red precipitate will form. The next test is paper chromatic method, and it is the most sensitive method as this method can detect as low as 0.001% argemone oil. Prevention and control measures. General public should be sensitized about dangers of argemone plant. Its growth should be discouraged and weeding of argemone plant should be done. Education and motivation of farmers about careful selective cultivation of yellow-seeded mustard. There should be ban on the sale or purchase of unpacked mustard oil. The next one is endemic ascites. It occurs due to the contamination, either deliberate or accidental, of the millet Panicum miliare, popular as Gondali among local people, with weeds, seeds of Crotalaria, popular as Junjunia among local people. Junjunia seeds contain pyrrolizidine alkaloids, which are hepatotoxic in nature. During the years 1973 and 1976, an outbreak of a disease in Nagesia tribals of Madhya Pradesh was reported. People suddenly developed ascites and jaundice, affecting people of all age groups except infants, and both the sexes with the high mortality rate of approximately 40% were reported. National Institute of Nutrition Hyderabad concluded that this outbreak was due to intake of millet seeds contaminated with Crotalaria seeds, which form their main diet. So, main preventive and control measures: educating and sensitizing general public regarding the disease and causative plants, especially in affected areas, removal of causative plants growing with staple and sieving of millet at the domestic level to remove the seeds of Junjunia, as these seeds are smaller compared to those of millet. Fusarium toxins. Fusarium incarnatum is a field fungus that affects crop like sorghum, rice, maize, etc. Found in subtropical and temperate zones, it is known to produce deoxynivalenol and fumonisin toxins, which causes diarrhea and vomiting. In India, during 1929, consumption of infested food grains resulted in moldy ragi poisoning, causing episodes of vomiting and diarrhea. Prevention is education of people and removing fungus. Prevention and control measures in relation to food adulteration in India. Codex Alimentarius, main structure of joint FAO and WHO food standards program. The CAC has framed food standards for markets at international level. The basis of India food standards is more or less than standards of the Codex Alimentarius. Second is prevention of food adulteration standards. They were established as per the PFA Act 1954 to set minimum level of quality of food article. Any food article is deemed adulterated if it does not conform to the minimum standards. The third is egg mark standards. The Directorate of Marketing and Inspection of the Government of India prescribe egg mark standards. It offers quality as per such standards. Fourth one is Indian Standards Institution standards. ISI standards also give assurance of good quality. Although egg mark and SI standards are not mandatory but purely voluntary. The fifth one is Food Safety and Standards Authority of India, FSSAI, founded in the year 2000 under the Food Safety and Standards Act Amendment 2006. The aim of this authority are to place the scientific standards for food articles to control and standardize not only manufacture and storage but also the distribution, sale and import of food articles. And other legislative measures are the Vegetable Oil Products Control Order 1947, the PFA Act 1954, the Essential Commodities Act 1955 in relation to food, the Fruit Products Order 1955, the Solvent Extracted Oil, De-oiled Meal and Edible Flour Control Order 1967, the Meat Food Products Order 1973, the Milk and Milk Products Order 1992, the Edible Oils Packaging Regulation Order 1998, the Food Safety and Standards Act 2006. So here we finishes the lecture and now it's concluded in the two parts. If you have any queries, you can write to me at akshay@healthandfamily.in or you can subscribe our channels for more lectures and more information on community medicine. Thank you.